A year ago, Becky's fund was just an idea, a flash of inspiration after Survivor Cook Islands. I wanted to do something with the small measure of influence and funds that I'd earned on the show. All I knew was that I could not sit by any longer while millions suffered in silence and shame from this ugly epidemic called domestic violence.
Every 9 seconds in the United States, a woman is assaulted and beaten.
Over the past year, the mission of Becky's Fund has evolved to include work on addressing and preventing domestic violence in our communities through community engagement, education, advocacy, research, and financial support.
On average, more than 3 women are murdered by their partners in this country every day.
I've been asked by students, friends, and even strangers on the street.
What can I do?
During this past year, Becky's Fund has helped answer this question, along with many others, by presenting at conferences, workshops, and colleges all over the country to get this topic out into the open, on the agenda, and to get people involved in this fight against domestic violence.
Homicide is the leading cause of death for pregnant women. Cancer is second.
During October, Domestic Violence Awareness Month, we kicked off our National Domestic Violence College Tour with a press conference on Capitol Hill. Both Congressman Mike Honda and Congresswoman Mazie Hirono were present to endorse this tour and give support to the cause.
Domestic violence affects everyone, regardless of race, ethnicity, religion, sexual orientation, socioeconomic status, or educational background.
On this National College Tour, we visited schools and taught students how to get involved. We discussed topics such as domestic violence in our community, identified the warning signs of dating violence, and shared practical ways to help a friend coping with abuse.
Have you seen evidence of injuries?
Does she give unconvincing explanations for her black eyes, bruises, or broken bones?
Does she miss work frequently?
Does her partner show an unusual amount of control over her life?
Does the abuser embarrass or ridicule his or her partner in public?
The question should really be, why does he batter? And the answer is, because he chooses to. Alcohol, culture, and a bad temper are not reasons, nor are they an excuse.
The response has been astounding. For many students, since these workshops are often the first chance to discuss domestic violence in a safe space, they've been eager to take part in this national campaign to stop domestic violence. We've seen these students apply what they've learned in the workshops to their own personal relationships, then go even further by educating others about domestic violence.
Women between the ages of 16 and 24 experience the highest rate of intimate partner abuse.
With the help of our volunteers, interns, and supporters like you, Becky's Fund is directly impacting victims of domestic violence by providing educational programs showing where to get help, informing our community about domestic violence, and presenting ways for the community to prevent another casualty from occurring.
November 21st, 1991, time 22:13 hours. This will be a 911 call position CT07.
Sending emergency. What's the sending emergency?
My mommy and daddy are having a fight.
Is he hitting her?
I'm talking to the police, Mommy! Stop it! Mommy! Stop it! Don't take the baby! Stop it! You're gonna hurt the baby!
Everyone can play a part. Please join Becky's Fund as we invest in hope for a brighter future.
It's not a silly little moment. It's not the storm before the calm. This is the deep and dying breath of this love that we've been working on. Can't seem to hold you like I want to.